All right, let's move on to a little bit of hockey. You mentioned the Blackhawks. They finished the regular season with the best record in the West. What's the feeling that there's another Stanley Cup? We talked to EJ Raddick, who said he's got the Blackhawks matched up with the Caps in the Stanley Cup Finals. What say you?
Oh, I know you'd love that. That would be right up your alley.
You better believe it.
Or maybe it wouldn't, because when it comes to closing time, the Blackhawks have been pretty good about that over the last 7 years. What's great for them is they've had a bunch of these young guys kind of get it, and you're seeing Panarin be a star. But that guy right there, Jonathan Toews, the fact that he has kind of come to life in the second half of the season, I think is bad news for everyone. Everyone knows that Kane is a sniper, that he's one of the best goal scorers. But the fact that you have one of the best two-way players, I think healthy and ready to roll, I think that he has learned how to pace himself in regular season so he can give all that he has in the postseason. I think that everyone's in trouble. This first round matchup, though, is always interesting. To me, it's right now, it's Blackhawks Blues rivalry and then Blackhawks Predators. To me, that's their best rival. It's a lot of fun. It can be a lot of fun this next couple weeks. And luckily for the folks in Chicago, the start times are actually good. Instead of waiting until 9 o'clock for two teams that live in the same time zone, you could actually have games that you can watch and enjoy and then put your kids to bed and they'll be okay going to school.
And they get past the Preds and it looks like they might get the Blues there in the second round. So both of those rivals that you mentioned there from the Central are back-to-back there. And I'd like this Blackhawks team. I think, strangely enough, they might even be better than they have been in any of their runs.
When you see the addition of Schmaltz and Panic and Panarin doing what he does, they brought back Johnny Oduya on defense to kind of give him some depth there. I think they're loaded. I mean, Stan Bowman I don't think he gets enough credit for in a salary cap era that doesn't really allow for you to do a lot when you have big money guys on your team like Toews and Kane. He has been masterful at building around those guys and getting just enough to put them in a position to win.